Here is my shop, number 19 in Boston, where I set up my business in 1924, selling tea and coffee. I also sold cocoa beans, I prepared myself, chocolate, and coffee beans. These drinks were considered as wholesome alternatives to alcohol, which we as Quakers strongly disapproved. And so as my business began to prosper, I was able to attract fashionable customers to buy my goods and see the colorful displays in my shop window. In my spare time, I experimented with preparations of cocoa beans and chocolate, which I could sell at the shop. Soon I had to rent a warehouse in nearby Crooked Lake, where I could manufacture these products on a larger scale. At first, it was very dark, as I had to pay high taxes on cocoa beans. And then, on top of all that, I had to move out of Crooked Lake and into another company, here, in Crooked Lake. That's when my brother Benjamin joined me, and together we formed Cadbury Brothers. With more space, we can now prepare a cocoa powder and an eating chocolate to be packed and sold. Soon after, my eldest son, Richard, joined the company. Having Richard with us made all the difference. He saw with that the quality of our cocoa improved, introduced new products, and even opened a shop in London. Our efforts were rewarded when we received our first Royal Warrant of Queen Victoria. That was when my youngest son, George, joined us.
George introduced many benefits to the workforce, such as half-day holidays, a sick club, many improvements in the factory.
And Richard, your new designs for our packaging were a huge success.
Well, we had to try something different, just to get ourselves recognized, Father, as we were still a small company.
I remember it was a struggle, but with everyone's hard work, we managed to turn things around.
Our aim is to manufacture only the highest quality of broken shop.
I know, and I can tell you some stories of less scrupulous producers who added brick dust to their cocoa.
Ours is still gritty, but we only added sugar to take away the bitter taste, and starch to absorb the fat. However, George had heard of a new kind of cocoa press. He went to Holland in 1866, saw the press being used, and brought one back.
The Van Houten press.
Oh yes, Father. You see, because we can extract more of the cocoa butter, there was no need for more additives. Not only was our cocoa essence more palatable, but also output increased.
We became the only company in England that could produce such a pure cocoa essence.
We advertised and were praised in medical journals to improve the benefits of our product. Our cocoa essence sales increased, and our eating chocolate became even more popular.
The
Bristol
factory was now too small for cocoa, and we had to expand somewhere else.
For some time, George and I shared the same vision to build our new factory in a garden setting, away from the smoke and grime of the city.